Okay, so can you see this?
Yes, we can.
Okay, so thank you, Chairman. I'm Keiji Saito from Keio University in Japan. First of all, I'd like to thank organizers Yang and David for organizing nice workshop in such difficult time. In fact, I changed the title. Very sorry for this. My new title fits the subject of workshop, I guess. I'm talking on the microscopic heat engine and the thermodynamic geometry. So let me start with very general things on the heat engine. Heat engine was a basis to establish thermodynamics, as you know. Around this concept, nowadays, the size of heat engine becomes smaller and smaller due to the development of the experimental technique like this. The aim of this direction is to develop non-equilibrium thermodynamics and to understand the limitation of the thermodynamics and to understand the role of quantum mechanics and so on. These three are very deep subjects in this field. So let me briefly mention on the recent experiment of heat engine. This is the first micron size heat engine using colloidal particle trapped by laser trap. Changing the temperature surrounding the medium, they demonstrated the work extraction. The next experiment uses a cold atomic systems. Title of this paper is Atomic Scale Heat Engine. More recently, quantum heat engine is also demonstrated using NV center in diamond. The third experiment uses solid state to demonstrate the heat engine. So in our work, we all the time have in mind the Brownian type of heat engine that can be described by Langevin, overdamped Langevin dynamics like this. I explained the typical structure of microscopic heat engine. Yellow part is a distribution of the particles. In this four-stroke engine, we usually use the two different temperature, TH and TL. TH is the high temperature, and TL is the low temperature. Typically, we change the stiffness for the harmonic trap, lambda is the stiffness in this. using two different temperature, typically cyclic behavior looks like this. But in recent experiments, continuously changing temperatures are also used. This is sometimes inevitable in the practical control of temperature in experiments. So the cycle can be like this. This point is very different from the standard textbook setup. As we talk later, we need to change the definition of efficiency for this general setup. Before going to the main part, we roughly explain the subject of a heat engine problem. The first main subject is to figure out the relationship between efficiency and power. This is a schematic in the standard textbook on the thermodynamics to explain the heat engine. QH is a heat given from the hot reservoir, and QL is a heat into the cold reservoir. From energy conservation, work is extracted by this amount. For this setup, there are two important quantities. The first quantity is efficiency. Standard definition of the efficiency is given like this, and as you know, bounded from above by current efficiency, like this. The second important quantity is power. So let tau be the period of the cycle, and the power is defined like this. Work divided by the period tau. So the power is a work per unit time. In the Carnot cycle, we know that Carnot efficiency is achieved at the quasi-static limit. pre-stochastic limit means that period of the cycle is infinite, so the power is zero. Practically, this is not good at all, and so we want to reduce the period. But if you reduce the amplitude of the period, efficiency decreases. So we expect a sort of trade-off relation between efficiency and power. Okay, so the final goal is to get universal relation between the efficiency and power. Another important subject in heat engine is to clarify the role of quantum mechanics, because this question becomes relevant to the recent small size experiment. But today I have limitation on time. I don't discuss this topic at all, and I focus on this subject. So far, concerning the question about efficiency and power, there are several relevant papers. In this paper, several questions are raised, especially on the possibility of the coexistence of the kernel efficiency and finite power. This is not prohibited only with the second law, especially for the system with broken time reversal symmetry by magnetic field or Coriolis force and so on. In this specific model, with a three-terminal setup in the quantum conductor, that coexistence does not appear, even if we break the time reversal symmetry in the dynamics by a magnetic field. This means that some stronger constraints than second law should exist in nature. So later, within Markovian dynamics, we derived a kind of trade-off relation between efficiency and power with Naoto, when Naoto was a postdoc in my group. Yes, theta is a specific model-specific coefficient, but in general, we can show that this is finite. From this inequality, if efficiency approaching to the kernel, the power is automatically zero. This is a schematic of the power as a function of efficiency. So we set today's topic more specific. This is the general cycle in heat engine that we talk from now. As a function of amount of parameter lambda and t and period of cycle, we can find the two extreme regimes. This is a diagram of the amount of control parameter and speed defined by 1 over tau. The x-axis is speed 1 over tau, and the y-axis is the amount of the parameter values. Roughly speaking, the width of the cycle or area of the cycle. So there are two regimes. One is the regime of small amount of parameter, like this. For this dynamics, Kai showed a nice linear response theory using Fokker-Planck dynamics. Within this dynamics, we can get the details on the relation between the efficiency and power. And in addition, if the cycle speed is very small, then we can show that universal tight bound exists using the parameter theta that I explained in the previous page. So today, we consider another regime, blue regime. This is a near quasi adiabatic regime. The main question here is, what is linear response theory to describe the heat engine? And what is the tight bound on the power and efficiency? At the end of my talk, I will show a universal bound on the efficiency and power, written like this, given like this. Okay, so now the main part. I have Brownian heat engine in mind all the time, but the result is generically applicable for any systems. We use two parameter space, lambda, capital lambda. Hamiltonian contains small lambda, which this is a control parameter. The dynamics is given like this, L is the operator of the dynamics. We use Markovian dynamics because we are thinking on the near pressure static cycle. Using the Markovian dynamics is reasonable. For fixed T, the operator L has an instantaneous canonical distribution as a steady state solution. Canonical distribution is given by this using the instantaneous Hamiltonian at time t. Then we consider on the regime of very large period tau. As I mentioned before, we have in mind this experimental situation. In the experimental case, the temperature can continuously change. So we want to redefine the efficiency itself. To this end, first we remember on how to define the efficiency for the usual setup using the two fixed temperature. The target quantity is work extracted, and non-negativity of the total entropy production is also important. Total entropy production is given like this, using the heat. Because we are thinking on the cyclic heat engine, contribution from the channel entropy of the system does not appear in this cycle. We can rewrite this like this, and the non-negativity of the total entropy production means that this part is non-negative. Then we define the efficiency like this. The numerator should be the work because this quantity is the target value. Then efficiency is bounded from above by one from the non-negativity of the entropy production. Having this in mind, we try to define the efficiency for general case where temperature can continuously change. For general case, we use following efficiency. The target quantity is again work extracted. From the standard framework of stochastic thermodynamics, time derivative of the work is given by this formula. In addition to this, we define new quantity U like this. Here, S is a system's entropy calculated by channel entropy that Yang mentioned in the introduction. This term can be regarded as uptake of the energy from the thermal reservoir. Actually, we can show that in the quasi-static limit, this quantity exactly becomes the uptake heat from the thermal bath. So now we introduce a quantity A, which is defined like this by the combination of U and W. As shown later, this quantity is non-negative. From the same story that I explained in the previous page, we define the following efficiency, putting the work in the numerator like this. From non-negativity of the quantity A, this quantity is bounded from above by one. So in general, experimental measurement of heat is very difficult, especially calorimetric measurement is extremely difficult. But for small system size in classical systems, distribution is relatively easy by measurement, by performing the experiment iteratively. Then the U is computable object and relatively easier than measuring the heat itself. Then we use this definition. Let me briefly show you about the non-negativity of the quantity A. A is defined like this. It's easy to show the non-negativity. We start with the non-negativity of the total entropy production rate because entropy production rate is always negative, non-negative for each time t. Then we can multiply it by arbitrary positive function. We put time-dependent temperature like this. Then next we notice that we can put this term. E minus TS is a free energy, and free energy is a function of state of the system, and so the integration over the cycle vanishes. That's why we can safely put this term here, and the combination of these two terms becomes A, quantity A. So like this, we can show non-negativity. So now we get into the detail. We are interested in near quasi-static process. The dynamics is given by this. Then we make an adiabatic expansion. 1 over tau is a small parameter now, and so expands the solution of distribution in terms of 1 over tau, like this. The zeroth order is an instantaneous equilibrium distribution. The next order is given by this expression. Formally, we can write in this way. This term is the order of 1 over tau, and we use the expansion up to the first order. So using this expansion for the distribution, we also expand the time derivative of the work and system entropy, like this. The expression of leading order is given by the equilibrium distribution. The next order is computed by the first order of distribution. R is a linear response expansion with respect to a control parameter. The time derivative of the parameter at small value, because we are thinking the small speed. And so this expansion is reasonable. By symmetrizing the matrix R like this, with defining the new matrix G, then we can show that the quantity A is expanded using the bilinear form like this. The nice thing is that the quantity A is a function of the control parameter. That's why we use this quantity. So next, we show you the quantity A is nicely bounded by purely geometrical quantity. For a given counter cycle, we use Schwarz inequality for this. This is a definition of the quantity that by expansion from the instantaneous equilibrium distribution. And we can show that the quantity A is bounded below by the quantity L and tau. Tau is the period of the cycle. And this quantity L is thermodynamic range, written like this. And I want to stress that this quantity is a purely geometrical quantity calculated by the counter C. So for this quantity, I have several comments. First remark is that, as I said, thermodynamic length depends only on the counter C and purely geometrical quantities. So we can say that the geometric quantity bounds the non-equilibrium function A. The second remark is that is about the terminology. In the past, there are many types of thermodynamic lengths for thermodynamic lengths. Most of them are defined in equilibrium case. In our case, we define the thermodynamic lengths for non-equilibrium situation. Garvin-Crookes has a nice paper on the thermodynamic lengths in non-equilibrium situation. So roughly speaking, the thermodynamic length is a measure of dissipation for a given cycle, for a given thermodynamic cycle.
Okay, three minutes to go.
Okay. So nice thing on this bound is the following. From this bound, we can derive the trade-off relation between efficiency and power, like this. Here, calligraphic W on calligraphic W is a work in the quasi-static limit along the cycle. So again, this W is a purely geometrical quantity. And so this term is a geometrical quantity. And the background to get this inequality is to use Schwarz inequality. So we can identify the equality condition mathematically about this inequality. Then we can find the optimum protocol to get the inequality. So in this sense, this inequality shows the tight bound for the power. As long as the tight bound for the for general system, as long as we are thinking on the near quasi-static limit, quasi-static process. Let me summarize. We are thinking, we considered about the near quasi-static adiabatic limit, adiabatic regime, and we discussed the definition of the efficiency. And we made a linear response expansion around the quasi-adiabatic regime. And we found that the bound on the power is given like this. And I want to stress that this bound is a tight bound because we can identify the optimum, we know the optical protocol to get the bound. So next future work is about this quantity, because this quantity is knows how to approach the Carnot efficiency. So this, with depending on the value of this, even near perfect efficiency, power can be finite and be very big. So I want to know the quantity. I want to know the case where this quantity can be very large. So the question is, what is such system? So thank you very much for attention.